Hey guys, it's Seun and welcome back to my channel.
So today I'll be talking about relaxer do's and don'ts. So in my previous videos where I talk about growing relaxed hair, I haven't really talked much about the actual relaxer application, but I noticed that there is a need for this video.
So for the basics on how to apply your relaxer, I think it goes without saying that you should read the instructions that come with your relaxer kit. This video will more cover the things that aren't that explicit in the instructions and things that you may be doing wrong even if you're following the instructions that are written on the relaxer application. I essentially followed the same instructions that are given on most relaxer kits, using 4 sections, applying to my new growth, doing quick smoothing, waiting for the amount of time listed on the instructions, and rinsing it out with the neutralizing shampoo. But so now let's get into the more maybe not so explicit things that you should know. My do's and don'ts.
So yeah, I think the very first and biggest thing is just putting too much, like going too far with relaxer on your head. Whenever a lot of people apply relaxer, it's like it's smooth all the way up to where it bunches together right here. That means you're going from here all the way here. That's like at least an extra 2 or 3 inches of new growth of growth that isn't new, that you're over applying your relaxer to. You would have had to stretch for like a year for your hair to need that much relaxer.
But you could save yourself from having to stretch for that long by just having a better process of relaxing your hair when you do relax it.
I'm going to like quickly demonstrate how, in case you're wondering, okay, well, like how do I actually not do that, because I don't know how to avoid getting my relaxer on that much. So I think the one where it goes wrong is the smoothing. Like, so whenever you apply it the first time, you do boom, boom, and then section it, boom, boom. And then, so I think that part is where we generally get it right. But whenever you come back through and smooth, for some reason, it's like we want to smooth it all the way past where it needs to go. Being more deliberate with how it's applied at the beginning so that you don't have to do as much smoothing. And another thing is you don't have to comb the relaxer through your hair for it to get straighter. The relaxer and the chemicals will do the straightening job on its own, whether or not your hair is combed out. Like, just having the product on your hair is what will get it straight. Combing can be beneficial because it can help distribute the product through your hair better, but if you're just more deliberate about how you apply the relaxer in the first place, you can avoid that, so that whenever the smoothing part comes in, you really don't have to do much to distribute the relaxer through your hair because your hair already has an ample amount of relaxer on it, and having enough relaxer on it is what will get it the most straight.
Now I'm just going to quickly demonstrate using conditioner how I apply the relaxer so I don't have to do as heavy smoothing later on.
So when you're applying your relaxer, first you want to make sure that your hair is as detangled as possible, because I know it's going to be kind of hard, especially if you have a lot of new growth, to properly detangle your hair, but making sure that your hair is completely detangled before you start applying the relaxer makes the relaxer application process go so much faster. When you're doing it, you want to make sure that your finger, if you're using your finger or your application brush, whatever you're using to apply your relaxer, you want to make sure that it's very saturated with the relaxer and just like there's just a lot of it on. And what you're going to do, make sure it's not too much where it'll drip and like could possibly fall on your eye, but like a lot like this. And having a lot on the brush or your finger will make it really easy to apply a lot to your hair. So you literally just apply it straight on to however much new growth you have. And that's usually how far up I go for like a 2-month stretch. Whenever you have new growth, your hair is shrunken. So it's like half the stretched length. So this is actually much longer than it appears when you're applying the relaxer, because your hair, so I don't have that much new growth right now, but in reality, when I stretch this portion out, it would be almost double of what it appears to be. So even though you're only applying like a little, you're covering a lot of space, and you can just eye it yourself and see where your hair stops being straight. But for me, it's usually around this much. Then I grab the end of a comb and literally just part my hair. And then whenever you part it, you want to make sure that you can see some of the relaxer peeping through the end. That means you have applied enough, or you're taking a piece that is small enough. If you get a piece, if you were to part your hair right here and you didn't see any relaxer, and you were to apply relaxer right here, all of this in the middle, would it have enough relaxer on it? So I want to make sure that when you're flipping it over, you're able to see some of that white peeping through. And then what you're going to do, making sure that the brush is as saturated as possible with relaxer, and then applying it to the opposite end, like so, and then repeating what you just did on this side with this side, and then continuing on the process as you go on.
And then so once I'm finished applying the relaxer throughout my head, I go back and gently use my fingers to very lightly smooth. I don't spend too much time smoothing. Literally takes me under a minute to just put my fingers through and further distribute the relaxer through my head without raking the relaxer any higher up.
In terms of how long you should let your hair process, it depends on your hair specifically and like the thickness of it all. And definitely for that, especially check the actual instructions on the relaxer. So they specifically said, same, if you have thick hair, leave it in for this long. If you have thin hair, leave it in for this long. And thin meaning like fine, not like how much hair is on your head. But yeah, follow those instructions. If you're someone that takes longer to apply your relaxer and you don't want to rush the process because that means you might not be applying enough, or you might be applying it too far down, like it'll be all over your scalp, all of that. If you're rushing and you just want to take your time, you don't have to relax it all at once. I think it was long time ago, I saw a video of someone just like doing their hair, relaxing their hair in two parts, and I'm like, wow, that's actually really smart. So that's something that I personally do. When I say that, it sounds kind of hard. Like, okay, how am I only going to apply it to half of my head and then wash it out, but only wash half of my head, won't the other half? Like, how does that work? But basically what I do is I grab a shower cap. I put the shower cap on, and then I grab a bobby pin and I pin it down. And then I move it all the way back to back of my head, and I grab a bobby pin and I pin it down in the back as well, and then it stays like that. That's basically how I am able to do my hair in two sections without having to worry about like applying relaxer, actually getting the relaxer on the other half. Whenever I'm rinsing my head, I just turn my head, because it has the shower cap on it, it helps with like not letting the relaxer splash on it or anything like that, and then it doesn't get wet. Actually thoroughly wash and finish the whole process for this half of your head before moving on to this half of your head. If you're using a relaxer where the shampoo isn't color coded, find one that is, like I feel like majority are, and it really helps with knowing when your hair is properly neutralized and all of that. But yeah, and then so once that is done, I put the side in the bun, use the shower cap, do the exact same process on the other side. If you are someone who can apply your relaxer all at once, I don't necessarily recommend doing the half and half. It's kind of a lot. So if you're someone who can do it all at once, definitely continue doing it all at once. That's just something that I personally have to do, knowing myself. So yeah, I think that is the main tip for properly applying it. And another thing is, if you are not going for the Textlax texture, process your hair, like allow your hair to process. I think it's easy sometimes to, like especially if you're doing it in this way, half and half, or maybe if you're really fast and you don't want your hair to be over processed, you accidentally under process it. That's definitely better than over processing it. But under processing, I feel like it's also a problem. There was like a section of my hair that was under processed. And I remember this section would always get so tangled. My hair was tangling more and it was breaking more because it was so under processed. But basically all that is to say that like, be careful not to under process your hair, because it, like even though you think that you're trying to save your hair, and this is if you're not going for the Textlax texture, which I know a lot of people do, but if you are going for the straighter texture, even my hair doesn't ever get bone straight because of the thickness and all of that, but I'm still not going for that much, like too much texture in it. Allow your hair to process, not over process, but process, because under processing has its own problems too. But anyways, this also applies to everyone. Whether you're doing it half and half or doing all of your hair at once, rinse your hair in the order that you apply the relaxer. So for me, if that's like starting with the front of my head, then I will thoroughly rinse the front of my head first and then gradually move to the back so that the processing time is a little bit more even for all of my hair. And then another thing that I didn't mention earlier is you have to know your hair. If you know that certain parts of your hair are more resistant, so for me, and this will be different for everyone, but for me it's like the crown of my head is just really, really thick and just doesn't take the relaxer as well as the edges of my hair. So I will start with that section of my hair that is more resistant. Even if I'm doing it in like the four things or whatever, I will apply like a little here, and then move on to the rest of my head. Don't just copy like what someone else does because their hair in certain parts of their head are more resistant than others. Learn what parts of your head are more resistant and then use that to judge where you apply your relaxer first. So I'm not gonna tell you, oh, always do your edges last, because that might not work for you.
And as far as how long you should wait in between relaxers, I always say do what works best for you. If your hair is breaking and tingling a lot because you are waiting 6 months in between your relaxers and you just don't know how to take care of a lot of new growth, you're really not benefiting from stretching your hair that much, because in between those stretches, your hair will just be breaking and losing any length that it's growing. So if you can take care of your hair well, stretch, but if you can't, just get the relaxer at your regular like 2-3 month intervals. I personally am able to stretch for really long now just because I'm good at taking care of my hair, but at the beginning that wasn't me at all and I had to stick to the shorter time intervals.
And I almost forgot to mention this, but I think honestly my biggest piece of advice for relaxing your hair at home is not to do it at home. And I know I personally do. Honestly speaking, the average person doesn't have that much time to worry about. I mean, so watching this video, of course, will help. This and that will help. Maybe doing it on one half and the other. But like, why? If you, and I know money can be another thing, but if you are able to go to a salon and you have a trusted salon, I think for me is I have a problem with trust. Like I've learned to trust myself more because I have been able to teach myself a lot and learn what doesn't work and what works. And I have seen that working for me. But like, if you have a lot of other things going on in your life, just go to an actual professional. Like, you can avoid messing up your hair very, very badly. So like, this is an advice video. Like, if you're already basically relaxing your hair at home and want to improve, this is not saying ditch the professional and start relaxing your hair at home because you can do it kind of thing. No, just go to the professional. If they are a professional, they know what they're doing. And just find a really good professional to relax your hair. I think that's honestly the biggest piece of advice that I have. Especially if you're just like an average person who doesn't, I don't know, it's a lot to relax your own hair, I personally think. So just go get it done if you have the money, because I know that's also another thing, and can find a trusted person in your area. So yeah, I really, really hope this helped you. I know people have been requesting it. I was pushing it away because one, I thought a lot of these things were kind of self-explanatory, realizing that they're not. And then also I was worried about like how I was actually going to film it. I feel like this talking video was actually way more beneficial, or at least I think it was. If it was, let me know. And subscribe if you're not already subscribed. I really hope this helped. And you can also find me on Instagram. I post hair updates and just tutorials of like the different styles that I'm doing, because I'm always switching my hair up, or I'm trying to now. But yeah, so I hope this helped, and I'll see you in the next one.